The Pennzoil Truck Series heads to one of its best racetracks on the schedule. We're here at the Rockingham Speedway in North Carolina for the Oreo 250 Under the Lights. This track hosts the closest Pennzoil Truck Series finish in history, 0.000. And on the pole for tonight's race is Daytona winner William Seaman, to his outside Mark Estachi in the 97. Then third, points leader Ko Luigi. In fourth, to his outside second points, Nathan Orman and Mathis Wells rounds out the front five. Then there's Cynthia Brayton, sixth. Seventh place is Oliver Galway's third in points. Then Laura Delano's eighth. Ninth is Rusty Shackelford, and Sebastian Kukulon rounds out the top 10. The rest of the field is Anthony Nez, to his outside Danny Bright. Then behind them is Jack Hanramo with Keith Stevens. Then there's Danny Lloyd and Walker Davis. Along with Trey Rainey, he's up inside the front five in points. Mark Silas Jr. to his inside. Then there's Colton Yeo with Marshall Burrow, along with Max Rossi and Julius Anderson. Then there's Jonathan Raines and Tim Randolph, along with Diego Yepes and Griffin Lynn. Then there's Joe Ward with Simon Bloomfield, along with Jake Galloway and Nathan Stapleton, Kashawn Richardson and Riley Spurleytube, and in the Fire Arts Racer, last season's champion, starting 33rd here tonight. So there's our 33 truck field for the Oreo 250. Let's go to track side and fire these engines up.
Drivers, start your engines!
And the engines are firing up here for the Oreo 250 and the Pennzoil Truck Series here at the Rockingham Speedway. Always a great racetrack, always a great race in the Pennzoil Truck Series. Lots going to depend on the tire wear here. If you can save your tires for later in the race, you're going to have a better shot at winning after 37 laps of action at the just over 1 mile Rockingham Speedway. Pace truck to pit road, William Seaman, Mark Estachi to the green flag, and the Oreo 250, it is out, we're green in Rockingham. Alrighty, battles for lead. Seaman back to fourth on the first lap, and Wells steals the lap from Ko Luigi. Wells leads lap one of the 51. Oliver Galway through to second. Yeah, we saw Seaman there. Lap one overdrove one and two. Luigi got down to the inside quickly. Now Wells to the race lead down the back stretch. Kukulon outside wall down the back. Keeps it going straight for now. Wells and Oliver Galway clear. First and second. Now here, Luigi up top three wide. Seaman to the middle lane. As for the lead, Oliver Galway beneath the 51 of Mathis Wells. Side by side, it looks like Oliver Galway led by a nose in the 27, 5 points for him, but they are three wide for the back, and is our points leader up top, Ko Luigi. Way up against the wall. He'll get in line by the 75. Great smart move there by Ko Luigi. Seaman down in line from the pole. I think he's outside the front 10 at this point in time. Here comes Colton Yeo inside. Julius Anderson is getting behind. Oliver Galway continues to lead. Mathis Wells now fading back through the field. Mark Silas Jr. trying to get down in line in front of William Seaman, who's currently in the seventh position. So Seaman gaining ground back after losing it on lap number one. Shackelford come with a run to Oliver Galway. There's a truck in the wall. Danny Bright off turn number two. Simon Bloomfield to the apron. Saves his truck. Now the front of the field single filing out. Hernandez from third up the racetrack gives the bomb to Jack Cameron on the 52. Looking low. And how about Mark Silas Jr. up inside the front five? And Ko Luigi has not found a hole in line. In fact, he is still fading back. Still up top three wide, the 24. Nowhere near getting down line. He's almost in the wall through one and two. Here comes Cynthia Bright. Won at Rockingham last season. It was the second Rockingham race, but she has won here before in the Pennzoil Truck Series. She's bound to the inside. Here comes Ray Sir. He started 33rd here tonight. Ko Luigi started third. And right there, Sir gets around the 24. It's very, very tight on the outside. He's struggling, falling back big time for Ko Luigi. Yeah, there's Ray Sir. He's up inside the front 20. Riley Spurleytube to the top 15. Remember, he started back there as well. Oliver Galway passed here. Rusty Shackelford in the 49 out in front in the Oreo 250. Anthony Nez to the inside for a second with Jack Cameron coming forward. Mathis Wells as well. That's the track for the 49. Hernandez on the bomb, digging hard. Now they're three wide. Wells on the 51 coming low. Big move for Mathis Wells, but that allows Oliver Galway to get in line in the third position. Can the 27 get down? No, Wells shoves it hard to the bomb. Get beneath that 27. Tight for the 51. Out of control for Wells, as they had a truck stopped down low, and that's why the 51 checked up big time, and now we have a truck blowing up at the back of the field. No caution, it was Trey Rainey that stopped, because Sean Richards is now going to be stopped. Yepes had to slow due to the 8 blowing up. No caution, yet the front four are pulled away big time because of this, as well as trying to regain, whatever he lost right there. And now the inside gets slowing because of the 8 down low, but no caution flag. So that's now two trucks that have stopped down the back stretch due to whatever issues. Four trucks break away from the rest of the field. Giving Rusty Shackelford, Anthony has Albert Gow, and Jack Caramo. Then fifth on back is a huge bound. These drivers have got, they cannot be happy with the fact that there is not a yellow flag for two times a truck stopped down the backstretch. Yeah, caution flag right here though with how these drivers are racing. Three wide, bouncing off the wall. We've got trucks everywhere down the backstretch. Yo, middle lane, Max Rossi down low. And these drivers right now, they are hoping for a caution flag because the front four really gapped the field. These drivers hoping they can catch back up. As there's the 18 on Perro, the 8 also with his issues, but once again, still the front four, Rusty Shackelford, Anthony Hernandez, Jack Canaramo, and Albert Gatway that pulled away, and then fifth on back in a huge battle, but the 18 is three laps down, the 8 is two down, and Diego Yepes, and the 3 has fallen a lap down, possibly damaged, as he does not have a hood now, he may run to the back of someone. He is now lap down, lap off pace, Trey Ray leaving pit rows for the lead. Hernandez is there, turn number 1, the 21 beneath the 49. Side by side in the Oreo 250 for the lead. Give it to Anthony Hernandez on the 21. Not quite yet. 49 Ballon back on the top side. Shackelford pulls ahead to turn number 3, but the 21 in the inside lane drives it down to that yellow line. Hernandez through to the lead in the Oreo 250. Now for second, Oliver Galway inside Rusty Shackelford with Jack Harrell in fourth lurking. Side by side for second. Fifth place is now Danny Lloyd. With Max Rossi to sixth. Seventh is going to be Nathan Stapleton. Wells back to eighth. Yo is ninth. Saki 10th. Cynthia Bright to 11th. This whole pack of trucks trying to fight their way back forward any chance they get. Oliver Gowen now climbs the banking. Look for the lead on Anthony Hernandez. Through 3 and 4. Side by side to the start finish line. Hernandez on the 21 leads. Galway inside. Cameron for third on Shackelford. Oliver Gowen then a clear through 1 and 2. He takes the lead away. Hernandez back to second. Cam Ramon, here comes fifth on back. They are closing in with those two drivers being side by side for third. Fifth on back is getting the draft off that they have closed in now. These drivers about fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, they are there in the draft now. They will close in if they start battling in the front four again. Mathis Wells Ballon at the four. Nathan Stapleton, two teammates, that's for seventh and eighth. They're gonna take it in the four of Stapleton. Up at the front, Hernandez back on Oliver Galway to try and get the lead back through 3 and 4, 27th at the racetrack. Here comes Hernandez to the bottom lane, side by side for the lead. Down the front stretch, it'll be Anthony Hernandez with start finish and leading the lap here at Rockingham. Hernandez third to the front, Shackelford looking for second on Oliver Galway, but the 27th that rocks the top side might be able to get back clear down the back stretch. Yeah, good run for Oliver Galway, but the 49 trying to get that side draft, pull that 27 back to him. He did a great job at Shackelford, now letting off into turn 3, trying to get the run off turn 4. 27 gain on entrance, lost on exit. That's going to be all it is. It's 15 laps down in the Oreo 250. Anthony Hernandez leads the race. Shackelford through to second in the 49 truck. Jack Caron with the third in the 52. Fourth place of battle now, Oliver Galway outside, Danny Lloyd inside, with Max Rossi here, Mathis Wells, Nathan Stapleton, Marcus Sacchi, Colton Hill, the front 10. Let him back trying to run down these front 10 now. As the front two have kind of gap thrown back just a little bit. Shackelford trying to get to Anthony Hernandez and get by. With Jack Cameron on third, Danny Lloyd now up to fourth, Max Rossi up to fifth, Oliver Galway falling outside the front 5. Look at this, he's front two up the racetrack, Hernandez into the wall from the lead. Shackelford followed him up the racetrack, maybe getting a bump, and the 49 through to the lead. Shackelford out front now, the Oreo 250. Jack Cameron to second. Third place now, Danny Lloyd with Max Rossi to fourth. The 21 falling back to fifth. Remember, he got into the wall. Hopefully that didn't cause too much damage to the truck. Doesn't affect the handling on that 21. Canaramo lurking on Shackelford down the back stretch. Here comes Cameron to the back bumper, but swings wide through 3 and 4, using a higher lane than the 49 of Shackelford. Can't quite get the run, lose some ground there. The 49 leads again. Lloyd, Rossi, Galloway, the front 5. Mathis Wells to 6th. Marcus Sacchi up to 7th. Stapleton for 8th on Anthony Hernandez. He goes to 1 and 2. 21 back into the wall down the back stretch. So Nathan Stapleton can move to the inside, and he's going to grab that spot away from the 21 of Anthony Hernandez. Look how these drivers are kind of going up the racetrack, trying to find where the grip is. Drivers are searching. They go up the banking. They climb that banking through 3 and 4. That's one of the turns where you can get away with it. And 1 and 2, if you go wide, you know, it's almost no man's land up there. When 3 and 4, you can shoot your truck, try and get a good diamond in that corner, get a good arc to try and get off the corner. Zero here in 3 and 4. Now, some of these drivers are just chasing their trucks up the racetrack, trying to find the right lanes. But sometimes you can beat that drag race back to the start finish, like Danny Lloyd will right there on Max Rossi. And Rossi is no stranger to being up the front here at Rockingham. When it was that margin of victory that was basically a tie, it was Rossi who finished second in that race. Who won that race? Well, he's inside the front 10 right now. Colton Yeo won it. So it was a battle between those two. Will we see a duel between those two again? Or will it be someone else? Will it be these two at the front? Jacopher is pulled away with Jack Canaramo from third on back. And they're nose to tail with 16 to go in Rockingham. For third, Galway, that's a bad entrance into the corner, a bad lane to enter that corner. He's going to make it work, though. 27-02 side by side for third. And then the battle at the front. Canaramo looking on Rusty Jacopher, looking for the run, looking for the lane to move. He just can't quite get lower than that 49. He's looking for a run down the straightaways, possibly. He's just not getting it. The 49 doing a great job, 15 to go. Oliver Galway through the third. Marcus Sacha, big move for third. Moves to the inside of the 27. The 27 slides through 1 and 2. As up front for the lead, Canaramo's there, but Rusty Shackford back off the top, gets back clear. And that's the same with third. Oliver Galway's clear of Marcus Sacha, but the 49 up the racetrack. 52 again, lower lane. Good run for Jack Canaramo through 3 and 4. Gets back to the back of the 49, Rusty Shackford. 14 to go in the Oreo 250. Bell still on for third. Sanchi back to the inside of the 27. He'll move his way up inside the front three. So he's going to hope that these front two once again get side by side with the other right here. And they have Yepes up ahead in the three truck. Yeah, so we'll see if these front two get slowed just a little bit because that three look at the 52 again to the bottom lane. Good time through 3 and 4. Canaramo side by side. Shackelford up top. Canaramo inside. They're trying to get sorted out to turn one. The 52 low lane for him slows big time. They'll get back on the exit now. Shackelford up against the wall, almost into it. Marcus Sacha, while these two are kind of balanced each other, and third is lurking. Shackelford once again drives up the banking through 3 and 4. Canaramo looking, trying to figure out where that 49 is weak. And they do have, once again, lap traffic. Diego Yepes is ahead in the three. Let's see how that plays into it. Yepes goes high through 1 and 2. Shackelford looking low off turn two. Gets tight beneath the three and gets behind him and down the backstretch. The 49 halts a little bit, now moves to the inside of Yepes, and through 3 and 4 drives down to that yellow line. He'll get by the three. Now can Canaramo do that down the front stretch? He will. So Canaramo cleanly around the three of Yepes. 11 to go. Marcus Sacha trying to gain on those front two. Canaramo looking to gain on the 49. Nice run up the bank through 1 and 2. Mathis Wells inside. That's third and fourth. Fifth place is Lord Alano out of nowhere. Here comes the 16. Up at the front. The front two kind of separate a little bit. Canaramo can't quite gain on Shackelford. And Wells now inside of Marcus Sacha to move his way up to third with lap traffic. Diego Yepes just in front of those two. Yepes climbs the banking through 1 and 2. We'll give the bomb to Matthew Wells off turn two and down the backstretch. Lord Alano has come from nowhere. Up inside the front five and has closed in on the battle for fourth. Canaramo still trying to find his way to the 49 and get by him. He has been on the back bumper. He's just not able to get around Shackelford. Under 10 to go, Mathis Wells, the champion of the Pennzoil Truck Series, to third. And now Marcus Hatchie, Lord Alano, battle for fourth and fifth. As the front two try to scoot away from the field. 97, Sanchi holding a bottom lane to turn number three to Alano behind in the 16. Once again, look at these front two. How high they are on the racetrack, up against the wall. 49 got too high. Got into the marbles. Ramo with a run down the front stretch. 8 to go. Jack Canaramo, good run through 3 and 4. Moves by Rusty Shackelford in 1 and 2. Oh, Sacha into the wall. Hard the 97. Drops back big time. Yepes trying to get around. The 97 falls back for 4th. As now Shackelford back up the racetrack. Wells is there in 3rd now. It's a 3-truck race at the front. Canaramo, Shackelford, Wells with 7 to go to settle. The Oreo 250, Shackelford looking low through 1 and 2. A good run to the inside. Canaramo off turn 2 and down the backstretch. The 52 powers off the top of the 49. Doing a pretty good job staying down there. Shackelford's inside. Let's off through 3 and 4 down to that yellow line. Canaramo climbs the banking. side by side, Rusty Shackover back to the point with six to go. And Wells now going for second. And with deep rebound, look at Morgulov for fourth, closing into the 16. And Simon Bloomfield, don't look now, up to fifth. Does he have a chance at this thing? Wells will need to get clear right here to try and keep touch with Shackelford. Five laps of racing to go. We're at the point of no return. Yellow flag would end the race. Five to go in the Oreo 250. It's Shackelford, Wells, Delano. 1-2-3, Cameron a fourth, Bloomfield fifth. Wells trying to block the 16 down low, down the backstretch. Just staying down low, the 16 couldn't make the move. Now in 3 and 4, three distinct lanes being used right there. Shackelford the high lane, Wells the middle lane, Delano the low, low lane. Four to go right here. Three truck race at the front for the win in the Oreo 250. Rusty Shackelford leads in the 49. Mathis Wells is second. And you can see the speeds, how slow they are going through these corners with the tire wear. It would just take one slip out of the 49 like he did with Jack Cameron to allow that 51 to try and get there. Look at this for a second though. Delano, a good run down the front stretch, a big run. She's gonna clear Wells by the time they get to turn one. To Laura Delano through to second. She has had a long run truck from what we've seen this race. Can she close down Rusty Shackelford? It goes off the racetrack and into the wall off turn number two. Here comes Laura Delano. 2.5 to go, she is closing in. Can she get to the 49 to try and make a move? Two to go this time by, just over 2 miles left. Laura Delano is there, five trucks to settle the Oreo 250, two to go. And if Rusty Shackelford holds the 16 up, can Wells close back in from third? Or is Wells just trying to lay off and save his tires and make a run on this last lap? We're gonna find out. Coming to the white flag in the Oreo 250. Rusty Shackelford is dominated. He's out front. Laura Delano's closed in to the white flag. We're on the last lap at Rockingham. 1 mile left. Will it be Shackelford, Delano, or will these front two get into a skirmish? And allow third on back to win. Through 1 and 2, Shackelford, good 1 and 2. Down Thunder Alley for the final time. Delano closes in down the backstretch. It would take a move in 3 and 4 to win the race. Will Shackelford go up the racetrack and Delano get to the inside? Here they come. Another side-by-side run to the checkers at Rockingham. Delano inside, Shackelford outside. It'll be Laura Delano to win by half a truck length in the Oreo 250. We've seen it again. A last lap pass at Rockingham in the Pennzoil Truck Series. And by about half a truck length, Laura Delano has won the Oreo 250. Where did she come from? Out of nowhere, Laura Delano through 3 and 4, big move, and she wins here at Rockingham by about half a truck length. The margin of victory on that, about 0.04 of a second. Let's go see the finishing results. Here's how they finished in the Oreo 250 at the Rockingham Speedway. There were no caution flags during the race and 9 lead changes, 6 different drivers leading laps here tonight. And it's Laura Delano stealing the show. Only 1 lap she had to lead here to win this race. It was only the last one. Lap number 37 she led. She got to victory lane over Rusty Shackelford, who dominated the race. 25 of 37 laps led, but he falls to second there at the end. Mathis Wells, Jack Cameron, and Simon Bloomfield round out the front 5. With Joe Ward 6th, Marcus Sacchi 7th, Nathan Stipton, William Seaman from the pole in 9th, with Julius Anderson rounding up the front 10. As we look at the top 20, Ray Sir went from 33rd. He made his way inside the front 10, falls to 11th there at the end, but a great day for last season's champion, Ray Sir, who really just fought through this, starting 33rd, the last position, fought through to get up inside the front 15. Oliver Galloway led some laps there at the beginning, kind of fell back and never did recover. 12th place for the number 27, 4 laps led during the race. And for Cole Luigi, who entered the day as the points leader, finishes 20th. He started 3rd. He actually had the lead for about half of the first lap, but he kind of fell back and never could recover. He's actually lucky to get a top 20 out of this day here tonight. Look down 21st to 40th. Anthony Hernandez is a big name down here. He led 5 laps. He fell all the way down to 21st. And he looked like he was going to have a shot at this win before it was all over. And Cole Luigi does keep the points lead by a slim margin over Oliver Gowan. And that is because Nathan Orman did not have a great race as well. 28th for car number 20. As we look down, Danny Bright, Jake Galloway, the last two on the lead lap, 29th and 30th. They kind of got slowed, I think, by all the shenanigans that kind of happened towards the back of the field with trucks getting stopped on the apron and whatnot. Yeah, Pez 2 laps down with that nose damage. Trey Rainey 5 laps down with his issue in the 18. And because Sean Richardson also stopped on the backstretch, it was labeled as an accident, but looked like some mechanical issue put the 8 truck out of this race early on. And here are the updated point standings after six races this season. It is still Koluigi on top of the points list by a slim 2-point margin over Oliver Galway. That is one position on the racetrack practically. So Oliver Galway is now second in points. Joe Ward's up to third. Nathan Norman falls to fourth with Danny Lloyd in fifth. They have William Seaman sixth, Trey Rain down to seventh, Tim Randolph, Anthony Hernandez, and Max Rossi hold the final spots inside the front 10. Looking at the top 20, Stipton is only 5 points out of the front 10. Marcus Sachi, Mathis Wells, Ray Sir, all kind of within the vicinity of that. Ray Sir currently holds a wildcard spot with a win in the 14th position since there are no other winners here. 11th place, Nathan Stipton gets the other wild card. As we look down 21st to 40th, you see down here, Lord Alano and Jonathan Raines are two winners below the top 20 points. Delano is currently 22nd in points, about 25 behind Walker Davis, so not too big of a gap there, but for Jonathan Raines, I would say over 50 points back, maybe even 75 points back, somewhere around there. So for Jonathan Raines, he's going to have to be on his A game these next few races to try and make a wild card spot. Another win would do wonders for team number 41. So as you look ahead to our next race, we are done with the short track racing for now in the Pennzoil Truck Series. We'll see a lot more of that later in the season. But now we go to the 1.5 mile speedway. We stay in North Carolina. We go to Charlotte for the Mountain Dew 250. I will see you guys then.